Yet, and welcome back to Fujit's Blitz, and today we're going to look at the KV-5, the Russian Tier 8 heavy tank. It's a premium tank and it's currently in the stores, and I call this thing the Toothless Bear, but we'll get onto that later. You can currently pick up this tower block for 6,000 gold. But let's have a look at it. Well, there it is in all its glory. And it really is a tower block on tracks. I mean, this thing is huge. Now, the tank itself actually never existed. It was a cancelled project. And I'm not surprised why, because, I mean, this was just ridiculously stupid. Looking at the armour, boy, it looks pretty thick and impenetrable. But that's not true, because when I stick it into Armour Inspector against a Tiger, as you can see there, there are lots of green spaces that can be hurt, and boy, it can be hurt. Now, it comes with two guns, and again, we'll get onto that later. This is it with the lower gun, and as you can see, rate of fire is 7 rounds a minute. Penetration, pretty bad. The armor and the damage is pretty much the same either way. When we look at the hit points, we've got 1,600, and the armor itself is pretty thick. View range, it's not that great. Camo, what do you expect? It's a tower block on tracks. There is no camo, realistically. DPM on the lower gun, you've got 2,268. On the next gun, it actually shoots up a bit. Sorry, it drops to 1,949. Reload time on this gun is 8.4 seconds. On the other gun, it's around 10.5. Penetration wise, oh dear, it's so bad. 175 on your AP, 230 on your APCR. Damage, you're going to churn out about 320 on your AP, 270 APCR, 400 HE. Aim time, well, it's Russian. It's over 4 seconds. Gun depression, what gun depression? Top speed, it's a big, heavy beast of a tank. You're going to be hard put to get 40 out of this. 24 out of this. When I then stick in the other gun, you can see here, the penetration does go up quite extensively, but the load time comes down, and so does the DPM. And it comes down quite significantly, I must add. Now I'm going to show you a couple of games, firstly with the 107mm ZIS-6M gun, and then the final game will be in the ZIS-6D gun, the upper gun, so to speak. I personally used to like this tank, but it's been rather power creeped in its tier. I mean, don't forget, this is meant to be a tier 8 heavy, and it really, really, really struggles to pen. I mean, this thing, as with this gun, it's the worst pen of all heavies in its tier. I mean, I'm aiming for the top of this Centurion, and I just cannot pen it. It's just, yet it looks green. I mean, it's just awful. The penetration values on this tank are atrocious. Damage wise, it's not the best in its tier either. I mean, it's not the worst, but it's, you know, it's picking up the bottom, let's be fair. I mean, there are 27 tanks in this tier, and for penetration with this gun, it ranks at number 27. And for damage, I mean, look at that, you can't even pen the side on IS-5. But for damage, it ranks at sort of 19. I mean, it's just awful. Even when I stick in the APCR, it's just not going to happen. I mean, it is just atrocious. The penetration value, I mean, look at this, just bounce, bounce, bounce. But don't get me wrong, people have bounced me because I've got great armor. Now I'm aiming for the cupola. Nothing, not a thing. It just doesn't want to pen. Let's try the other hatch. And he's having the same problem as me. He's bouncing everything because he can't pen either. Oh, he just cannot pen this bloody thing. It is awful at penetration. It is just truly shockingly bad. I mean, I like the KV series. I mean, I love the KV-4. This thing, oh, this thing is like pulling teeth. It's a tank that you just cannot get to grips with. because the penetration is so bad. I mean, okay, if you're a tank collector, 6,000 gold isn't too bad, but why bother? Seriously guys, save your money, get the KV-4 instead. I mean, the KV-4 at least can penetrate. This thing, it's got shit camo and it's got absolutely dreadful penetration. Even if you put in calibrated shells, the calibrated shells on the lower gun isn't going to help you. You've got to stick in that higher gun to get that extra pen, and then you've got 10.5 seconds reload. It's just unbelievable. I think, okay, the price is reasonable, 6,000 gold, it's not bad, but you're not getting a great tank, to be honest with you. I mean, you're just not. This is the downside. I mean, it looks like it should be spectacular, but because of that penetration, it's just a damp squid. It's meh, and that's its biggest problem. You've got a big super heavy with great armor, don't get me wrong, I mean, if you wiggle it and jiggle it and all that sort of stuff, it is fantastic armor, but the gun is just truly pants. With penetration values like this in this tank, I mean, you're hard put to do anything other than bounce, especially with this gun. Now, like I said, it comes with two guns, and this is the lower of the two. And whilst you've got a nice reload of 8.5 seconds, it's hard put to hit a barn door, to be honest with you. Because don't forget, you've got a Russian gunner, and with a Russian gunner, you've got to be super accurate. And Russian gunners are known to be super accurate. And let's be honest, this isn't exactly the tank that's got pinpoint laser guided precision, because it isn't. It's that straightforward. And it really struggles. It struggles a lot. And I really struggled in this tank. I did all these games yesterday, and I really struggled in this tank to get anything other than a second class. It's also very slow, but it's a super heavy. It's meant to be slow. It's cumbersome. It's, like I said, it's got absolutely zero camo realistically, because it really is a tower block on tracks. I mean, this thing is colossal. It's huge. It's massive. It's really tall. It's so tall, if you notice, there's a ladder. There are steps to get up onto the turret. That's how big it is. I mean, it's just ridiculously huge. But I can deal with the size. I can deal with the lack of camouflage. I can deal with the slowness. What I really hate on this gun in particular is the penetration values. I mean, it's like you've got such a big tank with such a big gun, and the velocity that this thing shoots at is just like, you might as well have an asthmatic person blowing the round through, you know, a half blocked straw. It's that bad. It's like, it's truly shockingly awful. And like I said, I mean, I like the KV series, but this tank is just pants. And that's why I would warn and caution you. 6,000 gold may seem a good deal. And with that, don't get me wrong, I mean, you get, because, you know, it's got to be made worth your while, you get all the equipment slots unlocked. You get rare camouflage, you get 7 days premium account, you get 50 rare credit boosters, and you get an avatar. But you need all that, because, I mean, look at this. I can't even pen the size of a VK. It is that pants. Switch it to APCR, I still can't bloody pen anything. Okay, I've got the bottom plate there. But this is where this tank really, really struggles. And, you know, it's if anybody goes out with the lower gun, be warned, you're going to spend most of the time bouncing shots. It's just the way it works with the lower gun. But you'll get a nice reload time. I mean, look at this on the side. Can I get him? No, because somebody else does first. However, you know, we did an okay game. With this gun, you're going to really struggle to push 2,000 damage, unfortunately, because the gun is just meh. It just won't pen anything. I mean, it's just a truly horrendous gun. But we get a nice third class, 1200, the best. So this is the final game, and I've upped the gun. Still 107mm, this time it's the Ziz 6D gun. And, okay, your load time on this is 10.5 seconds, but your penetration shoots up massively. And this is, realistically, the only gun you should put into this tank. If you put the lower gun in, you're going to struggle. Stick this gun in, you're going to have a half a chance. It still struggles to pen. I mean, it's still one of the worst penetration values in its tier. And it's still not dishing out oodles of damage. I mean, for the tier, this is one of... It's not the worst pen, but it's, again, picking up the bottom. And damage-wise, again, it's not the worst, but it's very close to the worst. Now, okay, you've got to now struggle with a 10.5 reload, but you know what? I'd rather have a 10.5 reload and half a chance to pen a tank than I would with the other gun, which has got a nice, fastish reload, but ain't going to pen anything. Not even if you stood next to a barn door, it won't pen the barn door. It just bounce off. Whereas this gun slices. Well, it doesn't exactly slice, but it's a lot better. And like I said, I mean, if you're gonna get this tank, then you can only go with this gun, because if you go with the other gun, you're gonna struggle, guys. You'll struggle to pen. And as you can see here, in the other games we were struggling to get past 1300 damage. Here, easily get past 2200 damage without any problems. And that is the trick with the KV-5. Forget the other gun. Stick this gun in, you have a fighting chance, you can roll out and you can actually dish out some damage. It's still not the best, and I would still urge you to consider getting a KV-4 rather than spending your 6,000 gold on a KV-5. It's still a pretty packed tank, but it's your gold, it's up to you. You know, simple fact of life, if you haven't got it and you want a big super heavy in your garage, then of course KV-5 is the way to go, especially for this price. Anyway, that has been the KV-5. I have been Fujit. It's a great credit earner, as you can see there. It's currently in the stores. It's at a reasonable price. It's got a rubbish first gun, but the second gun's not too bad. By all means, comment and like and everything below. If you haven't already, press that subscribe button. It's a nice thing to do. If you have any decent replays, send them to me at fujitsblitz@gmail.com or join my Discord server. And you can also follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And until the next time, stay safe out there, have fun on the battlefield, and happy tanking. Because, you know, that's what it's all about, having fun and being happy.